Observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen. Tina, God's done some amazing things for you.
Amen.
And just share with us a little bit of your story, where God's brought you from and why you're being baptized today.
Okay. Thank you. I like that song, Save Me From Myself. Bible says, trust in the Lord thy God with all your heart and lean not unto thine own understanding. That's what I was reminded when I heard that song today. David the psalmist says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Because David the psalmist knows that in the house of the Lord, there is the presence of God. And when in the presence of God, there is fullness of joy. Amen?
Amen.
To those of you who don't know my name is Tina, you know it now. I'm originally Fijian, from Fiji, and I've been in medicine there now for 5 years. I've been in Canada for 15 years now. And Bible says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So I'm glad that I'm here today with you to share what the Lord has done for me. I was born into a Methodist home. I'm glad I was born into that home because the seed of the Lord was sown, was planted in me ever since. And when I grew up in my 20s, I strayed away from the Word of God. And then I ended up in the pigsty, I call it. I indulged myself in everything of the world has to offer. And I thought that was life. But that life was different to the life of the household I came from. I used to sing in the nightclub when I was in my 20s at night, and I worked during the day. And a thing happened. That day, there was something happening in Fiji. I was 26 years old. I had moved out of home, and I moved to a flat right opposite the first church, the first Pentecostal church of Fiji. And every Sunday, we would gather our alcohol and drink and sit under this mango tree that separates the road, the church and our home, and indulge ourselves. But the thing is, while I sat there, I like to hear the gospel music that's coming from the church. And so one day something was happening. The band leader asked me, can you please come and sing, because the person who's supposed to sing is not here. So I said, sure. I got out of work that day. My arm was swollen. I don't know how it's swollen. All of a sudden, it was there. It didn't look like a boil. Nobody pulled it. It didn't look like I hit it somewhere, but it was just swollen. So so there's a 16-year-old boy who lived right next door to our flat, our unit, sorry, flat we call them in Australia, to our unit, and he's 16 years old, he goes to high school, and his name is Mark. So I asked him, Mark, can you please pray for my hand? I have to go and sing in the nightclub tonight. God works in mysterious ways. I went and we sat with Mark, and that was like, hurry up, I have no time to sit around, can you please pray to God so that my hand can be healed so I can go and sing in the nightclub. And then Mark shared the word of God to me in the way I've never, ever heard it before. At first he said, Tina, Jesus loves you. That word alone, Jesus loved you, touched my heart. It's, somebody loves me at last. Somebody loves me. You know how we get smacked around at home when we were, and then we think our parents don't like us, don't love us. That's what happened to me. Rebellious child. Anyways, and then when Mark shared this, somehow I forgot about going to sing in the nightclub. Praise I forgot God. About, I just wanted to, my heart, not me, my physical self, my heart was drawn to what this boy was telling me. I was 26, he was 16, 10 years apart, and for a child to come and share the word of God to me, it's like, you know, nowadays, this time, this year, this lifestyle, people will look down on a kid who's trying to share the word of God and say, ah, kid stuff. Sorry. Kid stuff. But I am glad, I praise the Lord, that he intervened in my life that night. Yes. And then that very same night, I gave my heart to the Lord, and I received the Lord as my, I prayed the sinner's prayer with Mark, and received the Lord, and then 2 weeks later I got baptized in Fiji. And then my life with God was good. I was blessed, I got married, I have beautiful two sets of twins, all boys. I'm a grandmother now, I am so blessed. But in that part, I came to Canada and my life fell apart again. For 7 years in Canada, I've lived in a pigsty again. And this time I knew the word of God. This time I knew, but it was my weakness that threw me there. And while I was there, I didn't like it there. But I don't know why I was even there. It was like, so it was a pull. The pull of the world was just pulling me there. And then one day, we were like Sundays, sitting there and then hoping that to hear from and then at the same time I moved here to Bensonette, I was looking around for a Pentecostal church. So my friend got sick, I took him to the hospital, put him in there. When I drove back and I saw the sign and I said, Lord, if that's my church, take me there. But that time I was still living in the pigsty. So the Mormon people and the Jehovah's Witness people, they came and they put a pamphlet on my door. And then I saw the pamphlet and it's the same thing, it says, Jesus loves you. And then when I opened the pamphlet, it says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and give and forgive their sins and heal their land. And that's found in 2 Chronicles. When I read that, I felt so guilty. I felt so guilty, I was convicted by those words. The word of God is powerful. It's powerful. And I said, that day I said to myself, I said, I want to go back to God. I gotta clean house first. So, I prayed and fasted. And then for 7 years, and all of a sudden, God worked. You know, sometimes we pray and fast and pray, and then God doesn't, still the answer hasn't come. Habakkuk says, though it may tarry, it will come. So they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So that's what happened. And then as soon as I know that the biggest stumbling block in my life has been removed by God, because I asked him to do it, I cannot do it by myself. I said, Lord, I am too weak, but thou art strong. I cannot do this by myself. I'm depending on you, Lord God. And God did answer my prayer. So praise the Lord. Amen. No prayer goes unanswered. God is a miracle working God. And then after that, 2 weeks later, I emailed the pastor. Before that, I came here twice. We came here twice. And then I emailed pastor and I told pastor, because before that, pastor and I talked on the phone and he told me about cleaning house. You mentioned the backyard, cleaning the backyard. Something like that. So, and then, yeah, that hit home. Let him go. And he never underestimate the word. That just, you know, like if the Holy Spirit tells you to say it, say it. Don't hold it back. So I emailed Pastor and I told Pastor, I've cleaned house. Whatever you told me, whatever we talked about on the phone, I've done. I've cleaned house. I've recommitted my life to the Lord. I've prayed the sinner's prayer, and I want to go to God and serve Him as and dedicate my time for Him, and I want to be baptized. So, because I want to bury my old self and resurrect a new creation. Amen? Amen. I prepared a different thing altogether. Bible says, those who live in the shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shelter of Almighty. That's in Psalms 91, verse 1. And I'm glad that God touched me that day. I'm glad that enabled me to stand up here today and to share with you the word of God. The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And then we've got to take that and run with that word.
Yes, amen.
Because if we're going to sit back and expect God to come from heaven and hold our hand and take us, no. And the Holy Spirit is already there. If it convicts your heart, say Jesus loves you to somebody. If it convicts your heart, go and do something that is according to His word. Amen?
Amen.
Matthew chapter 5 verse 6 says, blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Yes.
This is the time to hunger and thirst after righteousness. We are living in the last days.
Yes, yes.
A lot of things are happening. A lot of things are happening around us. And these are the signs. Jesus said, I will give you signs and wonders. We don't know when Jesus is going to come back. I'm looking forward to the day because I know my name is there too. And your name is there too. And if your name is not there, this is the time to seek the Lord while He may be found.
Yes, that's right.
Amen?
That's right.
Verse 8 says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. I like that verse. We must, and I like to encourage us. We are living in the last days. Bible says, today is the day of salvation. Now is the appointed time. Not tomorrow, not next year, not next hour. Now is the appointed time. You don't know when you go out there, you might get into an accident and everything is too late, but now is the appointed time. Now is the time to come together and come together, bring your life to the Lord, like Pastor said. Dedicate your time and your life to the Lord. Lift up the name of God so that He will draw men unto us. The Bible says, Jesus says, if my name be lifted up, I will draw men unto you. Jesus never fall back on His promise. Right. And we don't have to worry about the seats. Yes, we pray about the seats every day among us. But there are angels that are filling up those seats. Amen?
Yes, amen?
So let's go with the Holy Spirit. Let us not go with our own understanding. Let's put God first. Let's go share the word of God. Share it. If you love your family and you know they're indulging themselves in that life, the life that I went through, the life that I've been through, that I entertained, just tell them Jesus loves you and see how God will manifest that word in their heart. And next thing you know, I want to come to church with you. Amen?
Amen.
Let's give all the glory, the honor, and the praises.
She doesn't know what to say. She's really shy and timid, and that's all right. But so we maybe do this a little bit differently, maybe a little question and answer. But can you tell us a little bit why you're getting baptized today?
Well, my whole family is Christian, and I was born into a Christian family. And I've been reading a Bible a lot, and I felt the desire just to get baptized and let God into my heart. So that's why I'm here, because God means everything to me. So I'm here to, you know, just leave my old self behind and come up new.
And we had memorized since, no, I'm not going to do that. That was the worst fear, is that I'd ask her to quote a scripture verse. and that's okay. The other day, I just really appreciated, because we talked, And you said, this is really huge for me. This is a big thing to get baptized. And so we talked about, you know, prayer and just the confession of our faith. The scripture that we shared was Romans 10:9-10. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God is raising from the dead, you'll be saved. And those are the two things, to confess with your mouth and to believe in your heart. And then it was, I think it was the next day, you called me and you said you had prayed that prayer to confess Jesus Christ, right? Yeah, that was really good. So nice to have that got firmed up, just to pray that prayer and know that that God's on it. I know that your mom's here, the family, that's awesome. And your grandma is, hopefully we can send the video to her. I know she'll be rejoicing to know that you're getting baptized today. So anything else you want to say?
Nope.
I didn't think so.
Amen.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, God's angels are rejoicing every time a sinner repents, comes to the Lord. Amen. So, Tina, I'm going to get you to come back up here. Both of you, actually. You can stay, Taylin. And we just want to pray over you before we actually go into the waters.
Thank you, Lord. Father, we bless you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, for Tina and Taylin, Lord, their willingness, Lord, to step out today and to be called by your name. And we just pray your blessing, your great blessing over their life, Lord. Lord, that from this moment on, Lord, that you will lead and guide them, direct them, Lord. Everything, Lord, from the people that they meet to the things that they do, Lord, for their passion and love for you, we just pray a release of the Holy Spirit. May it be a powerful thing in their lives, Lord. We just pray, God, that you would bless them. And as they come out of the water today, we're believing with them, Lord, for a life of victory and a life of newness and a life that is so powerful in you. We give you praise and glory in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Amen. Any one of our prayer team, you want to
pray over them? I feel like I'm supposed to say the scripture like the Lord wanted me to tell you the scripture. And so I'm going to say it like he's saying it to you. And it's Proverbs 3:5-6. And it's, trust me, lean in all your ways, lean on your own understanding, in all your ways acknowledge me, and I will direct your paths. And he doesn't mean sometimes I will direct your paths. He will always direct your paths.
Amen.
Always trust him, and sometimes things just don't, you know, they, I don't know, you think, is that God? It could be, but he's saying he's there. And Lord, we pray that they will always know the joy of their salvation, daily, the joy of their salvation.
Nice.
Bless them, Father, in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord. Anybody else?
Dear Lord, I just pray right now for the assurance of what's actually taking place. It's done.
Yes.
It's finished.
Yes.
It's already completed, Lord.
Thank
you, Jesus. This is just a public show of what has already been done in the spiritual, Lord. The old man has died. Old things have passed away, and you've made all things new, Lord. Their spirit within them is pure and holy as you are holy.
Thank you.
And they are a saint of God. They are not a sinner struggling with sin, because
you,
they are no longer slaves to sin, but they are slaves to righteousness, because the spirit that is within them, Lord, is holy and pure.
Yes.
And they are even seated in a spiritual way in the heavenlies with you, Lord, already secure.
Secure.
They don't have to behave and act to get there. It's been done.
Mm-hmm.
It's finished, Lord.
Thank
and we
Jesus.
Just celebrate in this act of baptism of what you have done. We were buried with you, and we have now been raised with you, Christ.
Yes.
And no matter what comes our way, and the thinking of the old man, our thoughts still need to be renewed. And Lord, we just pray that their minds and their bodies will be renewed, just like what their spirit is, Lord.
Yes.
It's, their spirit is pure and
yes.
clean and holy. And Lord, you're going to continue that process on them. And so, Lord, we just commit them to you, Lord,
yes.
and that the enemy cannot lie to them and take away anything that has been done, because it's finished.
Yes.
They're complete in you, Father.
Yes.
Thank you for that.
Yes.
They're clothed in Christ. It's so beautiful. And I'm just so thankful for Taylin, Lord, and how she is doing this at such a young age. God,
yes.
you have such
yes.
a plan
yes.
for her,
yes.
Lord.
Yes.
And we just pray that
Amen.
You will just... She will hear your voice within inside her, because your spirit is within her, and that she will hear your voice, and that she will just rely completely on you, because God, you have all figured out.
Jesus.
And if there's turmoil or strife around her, it's not inside her. That's not who she is, and we just praise you, Lord Jesus, for what you have done.
Jesus. Thank you.
as you showed to me, Tina and Taylin is like TNT, dynamite. They will be fighting for the Lord.
Yes.
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 Yes. Father, we bless them today as they are giving their lives again to you, Lord God. Taylin for the first time and Tina for the second time, Lord God. Father, we just pray that you would bless them tremendously as
yes.
they came out to Father today, Lord God. And let them be a new creation in your eyes and in the eyes of people around them, Lord God. We just bless them in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Turkey. Tina, Lord, and her confession of faith to you. Bless you, Lord, for her life, God, and her commitment to you. We just thank you, God, that she is totally in it, Lord. She's totally committed to you. And just, as was prayed already, Lord, we just ask your hand to be upon her at this moment of baptism. Thank you, God.
Thank you,
Jesus. Now, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we baptize you today. I'm not sure about fear of water, but that the water wouldn't be too cold. So, how is it?
It's okay.
All right.
Nice.
Well, Taylin, we appreciate you so much, your dedication to the Lord, the fact that you take things seriously. It's been good, and the journey's just starting. It's going to be greater yet. So, Lord, we just pray a blessing over Taylin. Lord, Father, we thank you, God, for her commitment to you. We ask, Lord, that you would bless her. Lord, from this time forward, we ask, Lord, that you will mark every way that she has, every thought that she has, every moment, Lord, may she know that you are in her and you are right beside her. And Father, we just pray, God, that you would bring blessing to her, that there will be nothing, Lord, that shall stand in the way, that there will be no one, Lord, that would be able to come against her. Father, we pray, God, for a backbone of steel and a word from her mouth, Lord, that is full of faith and truth. We pray, God, that there would be a confidence of the Holy Spirit. And Father, we just pray, God, that she would be bold, Lord, fierce as a lion with a back of steel. Lord, we just pray in the name of Jesus, you will keep her by your great power. We pray in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Taylin, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.